link it to climate, it linked to tectonic. As some people say that tectonics link to climate, climate links to tectonic. Both ways it is true. Okay. So you cannot avoid you cannot decouple these two issues actually, climate and tectonics, particularly in complex terrain like the Northeast, which is an active tectonic region. At the same time, it is a monsoon dominated, very strong monsoon dominated region. Okay. So both climate and tectonics, both of them you cannot decouple. Rather, you have to take both of them below. That the relative influence of one or the other that has to be worked out. In fact, it's a very huge that area of research. I think I could answer you. As of now, to be very specific, I don't have much data. Now, if you talk of the climate, we have got the last 100 years data, and there is unmistakable evidence that statistical analysis showed that there is a decline in the temperature, but that as the irrigation coefficient showed, there is a decline in that rainfall.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody?
Okay.
Apart from the river shifting, with the help of remote sensing images, what are the other miraculous elements identified in this region? Apart from the river shifting and
In my lab, we have done lots of work on that land use also. Okay. And people are using it for detailed geological mapping in thrust belt area. You know, thrust belt area, this is the thrust belt area. We have some measured one is called Naga thrust here, one is called Disang thrust here. Those two measured thrusts affecting the Cenozoic sequence, in between there are 8 different thrusts. Now, also is a factor that there are number of oil fields there. Now these oil exploration companies, they believe that there are lots of potential of oil and gas in the thrust field area. But this is a very inaccessible and difficult terrain. Going, I'm doing the geological mapping there, that on foot, traveling on foot, and it will take tens of years like. So you can take help from the hydrological satellite data. You can bring the first approximation of the position of the structural features, and based on a very detailed study of one traverse, okay, you can identify the geological units as well. But remember, geological mapping using the satellite images needs a very strong element of thin elements. Okay, only then it is possible. So satellite data we are using for geological mapping with that idea that it must be verifiable on the ground. Okay. Because it's a sedimented terrain, and sedimented terrain geological mapping is completely easier than the ground. Okay. So we are using it for geological mapping with the fear of giving input to the oil industries. And we are using for this kind of landslide studies, of course in geomorphological studies. It's a boom for me actually working in geomorphology and in land use like that.
Any other neurotronics evidence?
Yeah.
Any other neurotronics radiometrics evidence in this region?
I'm not
getting.
Can you please?
Neurotronics evidence, like reverse shifting.
Yes, these are.
Neurotronics evidence is a real thing. As I told you, post-plasticine time onward, middle plasticine onward, the deformation is taking place in terms of vertical tectonics in the region. You have got a number of paired and unpaired terraces. You have got stressed terraces along the MFT region, HFT or MFT, whatever you say. So those are also the deformed terraces. Okay. So this is a region, it's a live laboratory for neotectonics. Okay. So neotectonics is a broader term, and actual tectonics we use for particularly around last 10,000 years, I guess. So they are tendency measures, particularly in terms of those terraces. And those paleoseismic signatures are there. You make a trance, you will get all those the paleoseismic systems. Okay. There are signatures, very clear signatures.
Thank you, sir.
Senior colleagues and my dear children who have joined DSA Apocalypse Train. I was working in India. Many of the questions which you want to ask I have answered there. Even now I can answer, but I don't want to take because I've got some other work we have to go. See, it is a very fragile geomorphological terrain, entire India. So, by the way, by saying fragile, how much it is fragile? You'll be surprised. If you, from the cliff section Arunachal Pradesh, on the way from Meghalaya to Arunachal, if you travel, you pluck a small plant of 3 inches, the entire column will come down. It's not an exaggeration. This is the sensitivity of that terrain. Can you imagine? If you just pluck a piece of plant, entire column will come down. Because unconsolidated sediments, no rocks. It is a friable and all those things, it is some diagenesis is there. But here there is no diagenesis at all. Unconsolidated sediments. Very empty sediment. Very fragile. So you have to be very careful working in the area. That too, highly inaccessible. What will happen, you don't know. There may be live burial also. Nobody will come to know also because people population is very minimum. Second thing, structure, as he rightly said, you extend it, all can be correlated. But that study itself is very difficult to take up in that domain. Third thing, geomorphology, structure, and anthropogenic activity. What I feel, the main reason now, it is increasing day by day, this is due to heavy, unscientific anthropogenic activities. So with this, I am just adding something to this thing based on my experience. Now coming to remote sensing, he is from remote sensing expert, he is supposed to be a remote sensing expert. So this remote sensing point of view also, you can find out not many things in that area, which I have done it, not only for Meghalaya, for Manipur, Nagaland, some Mizoram, Tripura. So it can be done. Now, I respected our sir. I want to give a lot of thanks because I know him personally. When I was there as a geologist, I went to Gauhati University. We have got a lot of programs in like exhibitions, seminars, workshops like that. I went a number of times to Gauhati University. So that is why I told Dr. Tarakna Paul, since he has come here, he had to make use of his expertise. At least youngsters will be benefited by that. That's why you are invited. And I thank on behalf of GSI Training Institute and on my personal behalf, thank you, sir, for coming over here, sparing some time with our officers. Thank you so much. And I thank all others, you children also, for coming here and attending, spending time. Thank you all.
Thank you all because I had this question to be with you, and really, geologists is a small community. And whenever you visit, please come to my department. We have some modest infrastructures. We have some of the best microscopic facility. We have also added on FESM also there. So, all the great people working, and you please visit that my department whenever you get an opportunity there.